these companies will promise you that Medicare will cover the cost of it.
Yeah, they are promising free, but it is not free. New at 7, there is a scam in Southwest Florida going after your loved ones, promising free genetic testing, cancer screening, or DNA tests. ABC 7's Ross DiMattei is in our newsroom tonight exposing why it's a lie. Ross.
That's right, Jeff. Many of you may recognize this. It is one of several types of DNA tests, but before you give out insurance information, experts tell me it's important to question who that test is coming from and where the results are going.
We've had a few cases pop up in Southwest Florida.
Tonight, the Area Agency on Aging is sounding the alarm about a scam targeting Southwest Florida senior citizens.
Certainly, we do see older adults being the target of scams more frequently. But, you know, genetic testing is popular right now. You know, people do their DNA tests to find out their genealogy and things like that.
Experts say seniors seeking information about their family or health history are the perfect targets for in-person imposters.
A DNA testing company sets up a table at a health fair, offers free screening with just a cheek swab for a variety of diseases, and says Medicare will pay for it.
In reality, Medicare only covers the costs of certain genetic tests, and only if they are prescribed by a doctor.
So what happens is people are on the hook for charges, or Medicare gets bilked out of the money. This can be tens of thousands of dollars for these genetic tests.
A lot of older adults are coming in because their children are saying, "Mom, my doctor asked if you had genetic testing."
With the rise in popularity of genetic testing, Marianne Orlang isn't surprised to see scammers trying to take advantage, which is why she says it is so important to talk to a professional prior to taking a test.
If your approach to say you get free testing, I would be weary of that without any counseling, without any referral from your physician. Yeah, just be careful. Don't fall for those.
Now, so far, we can confirm at least two seniors here in Southwest Florida have been scammed, but they are not the only victims in this case. If Medicare agrees to pay for the fraudulent charges, it is us, the taxpayers, who pay that tab. Live in the newsroom tonight, Ross DiMattei, ABC 7.